So here I will try to show you how to plot a graph in Google Sheet and get the trend line and equation. So first you input your data that you measure like this, x and y. So we select the data that we want to plot graph like this, and then we go insert chart. And by default, Google Sheet will show you a line chart like this. So you're gonna need to change it to a scatter chart. So click here, come to here, change from line chart to scatter chart. Okay, so you get the graph like this. And then you can customize the X and Y axis. Double click, okay, you can change the chart style. Okay. You can change the axis and whatever, you can play around with this yourself. The important thing that we want here is the equation for your trend line. So close this now. Select the data. Select the data, double click on it. When we double click on it, you get this window pop up. And then you can scroll and see the word trend line here. Click on it, trend line. So on your graph, you will see a trend line appear. And by default, again, it will select linear trend line for you already. And this is what we want. So don't change it to something else. We want a linear trend line. And then what we want another thing from the trend line is that we want equation. So in Google Sheet, you come to here, label of the trend line. Click here, you see use equation. So if you click it, the equation will be shown on your chart like this. In the Google Sheet, we don't get to see equation y equal, but you have to understand that the equation would be y equal 3.28 times x plus minus 4.25. So the slope is 3.28. The y-intercept would be minus 4.25. So this equation compare it with the reference equation. Okay, this one, if you use Excel to plot your graph, again, start with put in your data first, and then we do the same thing. Choose the data you want to plot graph, and then we go insert, okay? And you can see this section here. Now, chart, click here, down here, we want a scatter chart. It said insert scatter chart. Okay, choose the one without any line. Okay, so you will get your chart. Again, you can play around with the axis, the chart title, and the axis. Normally, a good graph, you have to specify what is your y-axis, what is the value. In this case, it's going to be circumference. The unit of your circumference measurement is what you have to put it, signify it in the axis. And you can add any of this information by click the plus here, as well as the trend line. You click the plus here, and this window, the chart elements will come up. Okay, and you want a trend line. So you click trend line, okay? And then by default, you see a linear trend line as well, because it will look at your data and see what kind of relationship you get. And you can get the equation by click this more option here. Click it, okay? And you see more option. So this will come up, okay? You will select linear trend line already. All right, and then we don't want anything like this. You see set intercept and display equation on chart. This is what we want. Click here, display equation on chart. So this is your equation. So you see different between Google Sheet and Excel here. In Excel, you actually see the equation y equals 3.2824x minus 4.2523, a little more digit than what we saw from the Google Sheet. So compare this equation with the reference equation, same thing. Okay, and you can customize your graph to be as beautiful as you are and include all the important elements of the chart, like what is the chart about, plot what against what, and what is the axis, what is the unit of this value. Okay. This one is for Excel on tablet. Have your data and then select the data. Go to insert and then chart. Select XY scatter chart. Select this type. So now you have your chart like this. And then you can do the element here and then get the trend line, linear line. Unfortunately for this one, you don't have an option to get the equation for your trend line, but we have some other way around it. So you go here, layout, and then scroll to see something like this where you can see the equation here, this one. Select it, and now you have a chart with equation like this. Okay, this is the way around it for Excel on the tablet.